76, and it is the ayah. Let's say we start with the first one, saying هل أتى على الإنسان حين من الدهر لم يكن شيئا مذكورا إنا خلقنا الإنسان من نطفة أمشاج نبتليه فجعلناه سميعا بصيرا. Which means, has there not been over man a long period of time when he was nothing mentioned? Verily, we created man from a drop of mingled sperm. So that's the term drop for the moderator. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, the usage of the terms and the terminology has to be also used in an honorable manner. So you don't have to talk about really sperm as a sperm. You don't have to talk about sexual intercourse using the term sexual intercourse. But there is an inference to the concept, and the inference so that you'll understand it. So this is the Quran and the context, whatever the Quran, you will not find anything in it that somebody may accuse that there's some foul language in the Quran. So whenever you have
right.
a misunderstanding of the concept, let me finish this. Whenever you have a misunderstanding of a concept, then go to another area. And go to another
no
area.
Problem.
And then you'll find you don't have to go to Bulugh al-Maram and
Okay, I want one word from you. Now, this verse is talking about a sperm or not sperm, because what you are saying to me doesn't make sense. The Quran is saying this is a sperm. Ma'un dafiq, which is going to create the baby. Read with me, please, Ibn Kathir. And you will see this is a hadith from your prophet. This is a liquid is going to create the baby. He's talking about creating the baby. And your God in the Quran always mentioned that al-ma'u dafiq, this ma'u dafiq is the sperm. This is the sperm, min nutfa, you know, and the women, she don't have a sperm. If you read the description of that liquid, it's a fine texture yellow. So he even given us a definition, what kind of liquid we are talking about, where it's coming from. Now let me ask you a question. What is the liquid which is yellow and fine texture is going to create the baby? The egg of the woman is not a liquid. There is only one egg. The women have only one egg, not a liquid. Liquid, it means millions of drops. This is what the sperm is. Sperm is millions of drops. They walk together, they go inside the women when they have intercourse, and one of them is going to activate the egg. One of the sperm, one of those drops of the sperm, millions of them will go inside, but one of them only will activate the egg. And there is only one egg for the women. There is no liquid of eggs. Only one egg. And your God in the Quran insists, saying, we created you from a drop, which is a sperm. You know, this is why, sorry, I'm losing my voice. This is why you are refusing to read all the explanation I'm mentioning to you. Because simply all of them, they agree with me. Isn't it funny that always we say to Muslims, you know, let us for the first seat. So you know what? You cannot explain the Quran up to your mind. You have to go by the explanation of the scholars. When we give them the scholars, they say we don't go by scholars. It's very, you know, it's very weird. Are you going to take your scholars or not? Your mic.
Let me jump here and ask a question before you all give a response. And then I'm going to, we're going to have 10 minutes to go. And those who want to call in, if you have questions for either side, now is the time to call in if you have a question at 347-326-9268. If you do have a question, we want you to call in with that question. And we'll try to take them as quickly as possible. There again, I do want to ask the Muslim representatives a question. The Quran states that man is formed from the drop that is emitted from between the backbone and the ribs. Is that a true statement?
Yes, it's a true statement as you have read in the Quran, and that you can see the reference of what's known as somatogenesis. And really, I didn't want to go through what is a somite and how somites are formed and how the testicles are formed.
Okay, but here's my
with
point.
The kidney and all of it, and then the distance of the testicles.
That's fine. We won't have to go through all the development.
No. Right. We can go through this explanation, you know, it's no problem to us. But I don't think you have, I don't know if you have that scientific knowledge or Mr. Prince have that scientific knowledge. Actually, it's very, very detailed. And again, like I said, it's not only one verse. If one verse is giving some confusion for some people,
well, I just wanted you to... One moment, please. Yes. I just want you to admit and agree with me to the listening audience, because everybody is listening to what's being said. You just agreed and affirmed where the Quran states that man is formed from the drop that is emitted from between the backbone and the rib. I stated earlier to you that drops are not in the human body. They're outside of it. So even if that was the case, you still wouldn't have drops in the body. The drops, first and second of all, the reason that's a contradiction or that's an error, and the drops, this is a little medical terminology here, but the drops, the liquid, is not formed in embryonic development and does not begin that development until the testicle begins to mature. And that occurs after the birth of the baby and after the testicles have descended out of the body. So therefore, the Quran is incorrect in its statement that a person is formed from a drop that is emitted from between the backbone and the body. That's incorrect.
And I beg to differ, sir, because you are not reading the Quran. You are reading your mind. And I'm going to tell you this verse clearly as he read it earlier. إِنَّا خَلَقْتَ الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ نُطْفَةٍ أَمْشَاجٍ Allah said, مِنْ نُطْفَةٍ أَمْشَاجٍ That means a drop of mingled sperm. Now, since our beloved brother want to always refer back to what the scholar says, this is what the scholar says about this verse. As you may read with me, or you may listen and hear well, it says, أَمْشَاجٍ mingled because the female ovum has to be fertilized with the male sperm before a new animal, he refers to man as animal, meaning a being, can be born. So therefore, the drop you were talking about, and I just corrected you, the word drop in English does not mean something coming outside all the time. It means a little or volume of a liquid, wherever it may be in the human body, can be called a drop. And that is your American English telling you the meaning of drop. So why do you want to grasp on the word of drop as if you were dropping water from the bottle? This is how you look at it. But remember, this is your own interpretation, but the Quran does not mean what you were saying.
Okay. Okay, listen.
I want you to make your point. We're going to take some phone calls.
He is the one who mentioned chapter 76, verse number 2. This is Ibn Kathir in front of me. It says the water of the man and the water of the woman. The woman, she don't have a water, sir. The egg is not a water. And when your God Allah make say the water of the man and the water of the woman, read Ibn Kathir with me. I'm posting the link. This is not my explanation. Don't tell me your English. I am an Arabic-speaking man. This is my native language. I grew all my life in the Middle East. It says, this is Ibn Kathir saying, أَمْشَاجْ أَخْلَاطٌ وَالْمَشِيجُ الشَّيْءُ بَعْضَهُ بِبَعْضٍ Which means it's mixed together. قال Ibn Abbas في قوله تعالى من نطفة أمشاج يعني ماء الرجل وماء المرأة. Let me continue, please. You know, so it is the water of the women and the water of the man. It is equal water. What is equal to the water of the man? It is the water of the women.